Over the past 20 years, we've grown into a top-ranked biomedical engineering school.
BME 20 is a celebration, and it's a celebration of the 20 years of biomedical engineering at Cornell University. When you think of a pure research department that we started at with three faculty, I think, when it began, and where we sit today as sort of a full-service department with an undergraduate major, with flourishing research, more than 20 faculty members, it's a really exciting time, and it's exciting to look back at all the accomplishments over these past two decades.
So as our founding chair, Mike Schuller was, of course, critical to the formation of our department.
I mean, Mike Schuller is the single indispensable person in this story. Mike had been committed to the biomedical engineering effort at Cornell long before I got here or anyone else who's in the department got here. And if anyone knows Mike, Mike is committed and persistent and, you know, kept moving in this direction behind the scenes for years. And so when this opportunity came to start a department, he really seized on.
Mike Schuller, I think, has done a really smart move. What he's done is he's hired a small number of relatively senior faculty in the beginning, and then he was able to hire a relatively large group of assistant professors all within a similar time frame. And I was one of them.
Mike worked really hard to protect us and to help us grow those research programs. Although we're rightfully very proud of the undergraduate major that we've now established in biomedical engineering, we didn't establish that for 10 years. And that was a deliberate decision by Mike to allow us to grow the graduate education and the research mission first before bringing on the undergraduate program.
So I think the Meinig School of Biomedical Engineering here at Cornell is known for tissue engineering, very much so across multiple types of organs. So we have tissue engineering in the cancer arena, we have tissue engineering in the cardiovascular arena, and we have tissue engineering in orthopedic and soft tissues.
The roots of what we think of as extrusion-based bioprinting are all here, right? Our patents on the technology go back to 2004, 2005, where really there were only a few labs in the world, a handful, three or four at most, who were thinking about bioprinting at all. It's really exciting to think that the technology we invented here, again, 20 years ago, is behind the first 3D printed living implant placed in a human being.
One of the strengths that we have, both in our research programs as well as in our educational programs, are focusing on our core areas of research, which is in imaging, biomedical devices, and biomechanics.
It's very difficult to make effective progress on your own. And so that collaborative spirit that I don't think is unique to biomedical engineering, but I do think it's quite unique at Cornell, has been just essential in establishing the research programs that we have here.
I think the hallmarks of the department for things like collaboration and for diversity were things that started in, you know, a conference room in Olin Hall in 2004, where we said we were all in on this, that we knew that recruiting a diverse population of students and a diverse faculty would be critical, and it was a value that we had from day one.
One of the reasons that I chose Cornell was because I found a really great female advisor. I could see myself in her and the potential that I could have if I did follow this path.
And I believe seeing people who are in the position you want to be in the future and you can connect with on a different level is just very important, and it helps you grow confidence in yourself and then to continue on to your next step in life.
Well, I always find Cornell students to be really motivated. And then the BME students are really focused on making a difference towards healthcare. And we have a set of core courses that all incorporate labs. And the purpose of the labs is to really give them hands-on skills that they will need in industry or a career in academia or grad school.
The clinical immersion program is really a hallmark of our school. And it started out with a clinical immersion program for our first-year PhD students. They all spent 7 weeks of their first year in the city where they're working with clinicians, seeing patients, watching surgeries, learning the terminology that they then need to better understand the broader context of their research projects. So obviously we all have to think about AI and machine learning. We have to think about how we create long-lasting societal impact. We have to think about patient, no patient is the same. We have to consider those trends both as we're moving our research programs forward, but also train our students to recognize that.
I think what makes Cornell BME very unique is their active pursuit in building a community and an environment where anyone can come and thrive and feel comfortable being who they are unapologetically.
When I first came here, I thought I would be moving really far away from home, but I was able to find a really strong sense of community here. People from all over the world working in one place on really significant research that could hopefully one day change the world.
It's exciting to look back at all the accomplishments over these past two decades. And so BME 20 is a celebration of where we are and how far we've come in those 20 years.